Right, so it's that time of the time again. I'm not gonna say that. Mission inspiration, and I decided to cover up all that, you know, the picture that's underneath. I gessoed it 3 times, and you can still see it. So I just stuck this. It's actually a nice paper bag I got from Kath Kidston when I bought something, a little wallet for my bus card thing. Anyway, so the first step for this mission inspiration is to add a thin coat of gesso wall paint. Now my gesso is ridiculous anyway, so might as well just slap a load on. And that means you'll be able to see that lovely pattern still. Still a bit croaky. So, sorry if I keep clearing my throat or sniffing or anything. Okay, so that's been coated with gesso. Then, what was the next step? Texture through a stencil. Okay, so let me give this a little bit of time to dry, and I'll dig out the stencil, and we'll go from there. Okay, so I just gave it a quick run over with heat gun. It's probably not completely dry, but it doesn't matter. Just gonna use some texture paste or acrylic mousse. Don't usually use pink, which is why this one's pretty much full. Just want to do a little bit of this. Florally theme, I think. Down the side here. Didn't even look at the colour prompts. Perhaps I should. And that's really nice. I think I just want a touch more here. That's it. I think that frames it quite nicely. Very nice. Let's look. Gesso's lid's not on properly. Just tighten that on and move it out of the way. Ooh. Oh, dear me. Fingers and thumbs right, and just get rid of this. Excess fix trace onto my drop sheet. And I'm gonna grab baby wipe just down here. These baby wipes, oh my goodness, I bought these from the pound shop. They smell lovely, really nice, really strong as well, so don't think I would actually use them on a baby, but part lovely. So if you can hear the children outside, they will still be off school. What a shame. So anyway, what's next? I think it's patterned paper. Yes, patterned paper shapes. So I'm going to go away and find some patterned paper and do some shapes. Let me just get rid of the stuff that's overhanging. Yep. I'll sort that out and I'll be right back. Okay, so had a look at the colours, and oddly enough, I'm actually using the colours this month. I started with the pink. One of the suggested colours is blush pink. The other suggested colour is pistachio. So I'm not sure these are quite pistachio, but it's a greeny colour. that'll do. So I'm going to grab my circle dies and just cut some circles out, and I'm sure you don't need to see me do that, so I'll leave it in, but I'll fast forward. Okay, so that's some shapes cut out. Let's grab this back and just put my fingers where the modelling paste is. I'm not entirely sure it's dry, never mind. Let's see. Trying to figure out what sort of flow I want on the page. I think I like that actually. One there? No. Yeah, that's fun. Ooh. have any of this left in here. Yeah, let's use up some glue that I have that I don't use very often. And glue these down. And think about the next step. Add a vocal image or two. Now, I do have some stickers that I might use. Maybe. I wasn't sure if I was going to film this in all in one go. Or whether, because I kind of wanted to play with my jelly plates. I've got some great ideas, but I don't know. I don't have the motivation to do that today. I don't know if I want to get that messy today. Maybe another day. I'll just do this for today. I'm enjoying this. I was going to kind of do a couple of steps and then put this to one side while it was drying or something and get out the jelly plate, but I'm not feeling it right now. Glue all over the front of that one, so let's just give it a wipe. This one didn't cut very round because I had it kind of hanging off the edge of the shim. Do for the corner. That's really nice. Okay. And yeah, these are the stickers that I have. Do I want to use these? Oh. Okay, so what if we have that there, and then I'm not sure. Yeah. Let's just go with that. Be nice if she was a bit bigger, but yeah. Okay. What else have we got? Make marks with household items. Right. I want to find my cotton reel. I'll be right back. Okay, so got my cotton reel and I'm just gonna stick that there because I can't find my palette. And okay, I think that is going to be enough. Now I need to do something with that pink shoe. Just going to use that up and I'll be back again. Okay, so I think actually I want just a little bit more yellow. And I've got this cork. I'm just gonna add some more dots. Just here and there. To bring some more of that yellow in. There we go. And I'm wondering if just a touch of green as well. But sort of mixed with that yellow. A little bit. A bit of green. This too, just a little bit. What's next? Let's add a border. Okay, so I'm going to use one of these. But I'm not going to use it as a border. This is a border, but I'm going to use it as just a line, really. But it's still a border, so it still counts. mixed up a blush pink. Just stencil that on. Try and avoid my focal image. Not particularly bold, but it's there. Some of that off a bit. Baby wipe. Actually, I think I'm going to do is grab this sponge and this paint, and I'm going to go gently around the edges just to frame everything in. Try and make sure I'm not turning that peach pink as well. And that's kind of a border as well, I suppose. Because the background's pretty much white, that kind of gives your eye somewhere to stop, so just, don't know what you'd say. It's a border, makes it feel more finished, I suppose. There we go. Okay. And what's the next prompt? Add a quote using one or more of the suggested words. Nature, flowers, showers, trees, April. Okay, so I'm going to have to find a quote. And I'll be right back. Okay, so that was quick and easy. Now I just need to figure out how I'm going to put it on there. Let's see. Oh, that's small. No, too blocky. Actually, I might stamp it on. Okay, so stamps. And just gonna use this pigment ink. The problem I have with these letters is that I'm missing the little eye. Oh, that's not dark enough. That's not really dark enough. Okay. See if we can line that up again. Right, so probably speed through me stamping this because it would be very boring. I'll see you on the other side. Okay, so I've stamped that out as best I can. April showers bring May flowers. I hope so. Just make sure. Yep, I'm not putting that in anything monkey. And then let's check the last thing, I think, is for splatters. We'll check I've not missed anything. I had a quote, finish with splats, drips or raindrops. So, let's get some blue. Just a dot. Dot more. Come on. Okay, so we're running on the charger now and I've had to wind the tripod down so that it can reach. And hopefully I won't splash the camera because it's quite close. Here we go. With a few April showers. There we go. And I think I'm going to call that done. I quite like that. It's not, The pink is not really me, but it's quite a nice page, I think. So, I'm going to leave that there and let this camera charge. And upload everything onto YouTube. And I will see you soon. I hope you enjoyed it. Bye, guys.